We left 75,000 wheel vehicles. We left over 200 advanced aircraft. A few were disabled. The vast majority are still able to fly and are going to be valuable, if not to the Afghans, to enemies of ours around the world.
And Congressman, the president really had almost nothing to say in his speech today about so much of what happened in Afghanistan. Does the world not demand a reckoning? Do Americans not demand a reckoning from their president on what happened and what's happening now in that country to make sure that we keep our commitments to Americans, that we keep our commitments to allies in Afghanistan?
Well, these demands are going to come, at least from my party, not for weeks or months, but for years, until we get all of the Americans and their families out, until we, in fact, get to know more of exactly how we ended up in a position in which they say we have ability over the horizon. The fact is, to get to Afghanistan, we now have to fly over countries who may or may not let us fly over. We have no visibility on Iran, where previously we had very good accuracy. The list is endless of both military and foreign affairs failures that came out of this. So, yes, there'll be questions. I think the most important thing, Ryan, is that we as Americans have lost an ability to tell our allies, trust us, and we've lost the ability to have our enemies decide not to challenge us. So both of those are going to occur as a result of this catastrophic failure.